I think one of the most wonderful things that's happened to me is becoming a grandparent. Being a grandfather. Something that it's like getting a diploma of some kind, that suddenly you are a grandfather, meaning you are wise. It started in a great celebration, too, with the first grandson. That was the moment. And we all knew the grandson was coming, and all the kids were excited, and each kid in our family had bought a gift for the grandson, and we got flowers, and we had chocolate, and we were just sitting waiting for the phone call, waiting for the phone call. Finally, the phone call comes. It's a boy! Ah! So we all get in the car, and we're all in the car, and we got the flowers and the candy and all the toys and everything, and we go to the Vancouver Children's Hospital, and we come through the door, and there's the little baby, and we give him all the presents, and then we take him away, and we play with him, and we give him the chocolate, and we take it away, and we eat chocolate. We had a party. We had so much fun with this little baby boy. We had a grandson. We were just so happy. And so, 2 years later, when it was time for the next grandchild, we were ready. We had even more toys. We had even more candy. We had even more stuff. We were just ready to party. We were going to have the best time. And we're sitting around and we're waiting and we're waiting and it's taking forever. And finally the phone rings and it's a baby girl. It's a girl. We got a granddaughter. So we all get in the car and we're in the car with all the toys and the candy and all the stuff and the presents and everything and the flowers, and we get to the hospital and boom, we come through the door and we're ready to party and we're coming down the hallway. We got all the stuff and we're just happy as could be, and the nurse comes up and goes, "Mr. Scott, before you go in, we have to talk to you." "Yeah, okay, but make it quick, because you know, we got all this candy and we got all these flowers and we got all these toys and everything, so we really want to get to the party. So what do you want to talk to me about?" And she said, "Mr. Scott, we want you to know that your granddaughter was born with Down syndrome." "No, what? Well, what does that mean? What does that mean? Does that mean she's different than other kids? She's not gonna..." I can't know. And not my family. Not, it doesn't. And really, I had such shameful thoughts at that moment that I still feel bad about. But the other thing that happened, and it's really true, is that I realized for the first time in my life, for whatever reasons, I had been given the opportunity to be with a real, live angel. And the time that I've spent with this angel has been the most precious time in my life. I've never had such a feeling of, well, this angel that's in my life has shown me what fun is really about and what love is really about. And I've never had such a world shown to me like I've had the world that she sees, the world that she's in. And my life would be much smaller if it wasn't for this angel that was put into my life. And so in some little way, I tried to celebrate that event with the song Angels Do. Because I want the whole world to know how wonderful it is.